right every corner. Okay, some people be they holla say they want the power. Chai. Them be promise us say we go get light and power. Them hustle so they can't get the power. But now they know they do anything with the power. Sure. Every day, dollar just they get the higher power.
Over naira.
See them talk say, make we off mind. But thank God say, my ego don't come.
So my people make you lie down.
Oh, yo, yo, my ego don't come. Oh, yo, yo.
My people make we shut down.
Oh, yo, yo, my ego don't come. Oh, yo, yo.
My ego don't come, man of the masses.
Oh, yo, yo.
They do evil, no one make person talk. Them say that my egun, that man too they talk.
He too they talk.
Say my egun diary, he they hot like pepe. But every day, then they take money in buck.
Chimo.
One man picking, they the street they hawk. See them talk, say, make we no talk. But thank God say, my egun don't come.
So my people make you loud.
Oh, yo, yo, my egun don't come. Oh, yo, yo.
Hello there.
Ayegun la wa mo la mo dojo dojo.
Ayegun diary, ayegun pa wa.
Ayegun la wa mo la mo dojo dojo.
Ayegun diary.
Good morning to you, good afternoon to you, and good evening to you from wherever you are watching from. This is Mayegun Live.
Ashiri ajelu ki ipo ni be o.
Thank you so much for joining me from wherever you are watching from. Remember, share this broadcast. Invite your friends. Invite your not so friendly friends. Tell them, Mayegun today.
Mayegun diary, diary politico.
Mayegun diary, diary
politico. Godfather is in. Go see Lord of Mayegun.
Mayegun diary.
Just so you know, naira to dollar. This hour is now 1,251 naira to a dollar. Just for the record, share the broadcast.
Facebook.
Thank you so much. Read the caption of the broadcast, okay? Read the description as well, and then share it like the broadcast, okay? Meanwhile, the Supreme Court of Nigeria, 7-man panel, sat today to listen to the appeal of Peter Obi and Atiku Abubakar against Tinubu. I'm going to take you into the conversation tonight so that you will have a clearer picture, at least, of what happened. So many believe that this is a foregone conclusion. But even at that, a lot of people want to see how they want to turn and twist this. They are already doing that. Today, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to share that with you too. So let us start. I don't come You know, they will say, if you come anyhow, then you just have to start anyhow. So let's get it started. Good morning to you once again. Good afternoon to you. And then good evening to you. From wherever you are watching from, okay? It is Mayegun Live. And the long-awaited week is here. And this is the week that is somehow, has been the highest, most expectant week of October. You know, we've been waiting for so long, for so many things, including the Supreme Court of Nigeria, listening to the appeal between Atiku, Obi, and Tinubu. For the sake of, the importance of this conversation, so I'm going to use their names correctly, okay? Now that we are getting to that very, very important part of the journey of the young and the old Nigerians who put together the best of the best political movement that Nigeria has ever seen in a long time, called them the Obedient. They've had a very good run. And in the course of their movement of over a year now, they have been able to challenge the establishment at a very strong chokehold that all of us can attest to. Many, many people didn't believe or expect them to come this far, but they have proven indeed that if the game is fair, they can end the criminal enterprise in Nigeria, at least using their election. But in the course of over 17 months now, even the average of the Obedient themselves, they now know better how corrupt. And thanks to them as well, their movement has been able to confirm so many things that we have been trying to explain to a lot of people in the past, that you cannot beat them in their game, especially the game they set the rules. You can never beat them in an election if they have to rig you so openly. Not many believed that until they experienced it themselves. A lot of the Obedient today now know better how effed up Nigeria is. And that is why, now that we are getting to the last stage of that journey, some will tell you, no, Mayegun, there is no last stage. This one is just going to be the determinant of what is going to happen next. I say, okay. Take me on that ride. However, when INEC told them to go and get PVC, they believed INEC. They disbelieved Mayegun, because they believed that they have to have that experience to prove me right or wrong. INEC rigged them out. And the wahala of that rigging is what has now opened up so many other Pandora today. Majority of them, which has now led to the stage where Nigeria has now become a narco state, a fake country. However, they were told to go to court. Okay? And some of them believe too. They believe that, you know what? We are going to get back our mandates in court. We have evidence. We have all of the evidence to prove that this man was rigged in. I said, listen, with all of the evidence, the system is programmed to be like exactly what it is. It's fine. Go to court. And that was when go to court was renting the hair in Nigeria. Indeed, there were many other people who still believed that the judiciary could be the last hope. Until the judiciary started sponsoring influencers on social media in what they call, they were fighting back bullying. They said, these Nigerians that were demanding for their stolen mandate, they were bullies and they must never be allowed to near power. They've been called different names. And today, many of these Obedient themselves will tell you, they now understand what it means when we say the establishment. They now know. Now that they that believe that they are actually fighting for what should be the best for Nigeria, devoid of corruption, competent people, people with character,
Do you understand? So they have witnessed, and they are now witnessing it right now, that those they thought were responsible and respectable people in the society, they were part of the establishment. A lot of these young Nigerians have now realized that if they didn't participate, they probably would never know. And this continued to make their sort of, their anger to continue to boil and boil. The more they understand how corrupt, how rigged Nigeria's system is, the more angrier they have become, which is good. It is a very good anger. And I love the fact that they have kept it at that level, just like the moment they started. And I love them for that. Some of them are still hoping that maybe this judiciary, Supreme Court, will do something. Because all of the evidence were never looked into. All of the rigging evidence were never looked into. Because of technicality and how the witnesses were called, how the evidences were presented and time, blah, blah, blah. No evidence was looked into. Therefore, Kolu was confirmed by the tribunal. Now, you all witnessed that, and it broke so many people's hearts. And I remember on Mayegun's Diary Political, we learned a phrase then, which I told, I think I was the one who advised everyone that we should manage our expectations. Abi, I said, I know how corrupt Nigeria's system is. And I know how shameless they actually do things that are so illegal, and they will grandstand on it. I have seen them happen again and again and again. But a lot of you don't think they will happen again because you are interested now until they happened. Yeah? However, there are still few people who still feels like the Supreme Court will look into the evidence that the tribunal did not look into. The Tifnumbu's legal team at the tribunal, they did not call witness, they didn't call more than one witness. The entire INEC and APC, one witness. Despite all other witnesses, the Atif could call about 32 witnesses. Peter Obi called like about 12 witnesses, experts in the areas of where they were probing. They listened to all of the witnesses, so they presented all of the evidences. So when it was time for them to give judgment, the tribunal judges, you know what they started saying? They started attacking Obi and Atiku. The defense that Tifnumbu couldn't put up at the tribunal. Now the judges of the tribunal, they defend Tifnumbu. In one of the hearings at the tribunal, listen to this. One of the judges asked Atiku's lawyer on the issue of forfeiture of $460,000 for heroin trafficking in America. They said, that judge said, I mean, that was a long time ago. Are you not a Christian? Like, do you not, I mean, should we not forgive and forget? Judge, you, they still ask plaintiff, person with the, we bring a petition. Another one of them asked one of the witnesses that they brought in during the tribunal and said, if Tifnumbu, if Tinumbu was your family member, would you be happy that he's been harassed because of his academic record and his past? Now, judge, they ask witness at the tribunal. Judge was asking them, he said, if Tinubu was a family member, would you be happy that he's been embarrassed and harassed because of his record? But let us all be clear and very honest here. Nobody say all of us could be honest anyway. But let's separate facts from fictions. Tifnumbu submitted academic record to INEC, this same INEC in Nigeria, in 1998, that he wanted to be governor. The record, academic record that Tifnumbu submitted to INEC, this same Nigeria INEC, 24 years ago, is different from the same academic record that Tinubu has submitted to INEC in this 2023. The same INEC, they have the two documents, oh, the two fake documents, oh, fake academic records. Oh. So it is the same INEC that went to court and said the court should not take any evidence from Atiku and Obi. And judge, they ask, judge was asking, if Tinubu is your brother, are you going to be happy that he is being harassed because of his academic record? So why are you there in court then? Eh? Why did they say they should go to court then? So it was the judges that were now defending Tinubu in their judgment. They said the petitioners, Atiku and Obi, they are using social media to harass them. Now, judgment, too, they were reading judgment, too, presidential election judgment. They said that the opposite, they are using, did they expect them, the judges, to go and look for evidence for them? They came here without any evidence. Eh? They came here without any witness or anything. And then they went on social media and they started saying all lies on judiciary, all lies on judiciary. So do you want us to be the one to go to market and go and look for evidence to back your petition? Omo, now so judge, they tell petition now. Same judges that in their judgment, they said, evidence, exhibit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhibit, X, Y, Z, T, 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 A, B, C, X, Y, Z, witnesses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, hereby cancelled out of our consideration because you did not submit the petition or you did not submit their names the same day you submitted your petition. You only submitted their names later. So they removed all of the evidence. So they now said, are you expecting us to go and look for evidence for you? That's what they were reading to people. People were hearing the judgment. They were like, Nigeria is finished. That time, they haven't done Chicago State University forgery and deposition. So Supreme Court, they sat today. You want me to tell you what happened inside the court? We know why the Supreme Court is hurriedly put together. And for those who followed the conversation in court today, there's no need to tell you, say then go throw this thing out. You don't need anybody at this point. I will explain it to you. Just relax. And I have told you many times, for some people who are mostly impatient, am I going to continue, Jare? Continue. You are going here and the Omona. So journalism, as they call it, they say journalism is storytelling, even though I don't be journalist. It is called storytelling. And when you have a chance of narrating the story very well, the place, that place that you are seated now, that place you are seated watching me, what you are doing there is that you are now digesting the original story. So you are being helped to understand what the conclusion would be and how you should undo that. Everybody don't enter one chance already, as Nigeria is concerned. But by the time I kind of explained to you the conversation they had in their court today, Supreme Court today, you won't need anybody to tell you that they are going to throw everything out and they are going to legitimize Tinubu. Okay, the conversation of the justices today, their line of questioning, don't give the answer already. But don't worry, we'll get there. Back in America, Tinubu is not giving up on trying to delay the FBI document release. I also say it's a criminal record or the release. He's doing everything to delay it. He knows that he can't stop it. Shall you get? Today, Aaron Greenspan and his chambers that filed that because of this FBI, CIA, Internal Revenue, and also about five of United States of America's government agencies are being sued. And what Tinubu is asking for is that in court in America right now is that please tell them not to release the documents now. Okay? Please, just let them give me a few days before they will do it. Meanwhile, Aaron Greenspan, who is demanding for that release and all that, yeah, is filing a motion, has filed a motion last week Friday, and they expected the court to rule on that today. That was when Tinubu brought his own case. This is it. Sorry, it's a long story there. I'll tell you the content, okay? And in all of these things they wrote inside here, what they are begging for is that if they release the documents now, they are going to destroy him. And his political opposition, they are going to use it against him and they can bring down Nigeria. This is what they have in all of this. So they are begging American courts to tell FBI to hold on. While in Nigeria, Tinubu have succeeded in making sure that the Supreme Court of Nigeria quickly, hurriedly, come together and listen to whatever Atiku and Obi say they want to say, okay? And give their judgment. And as you are watching this video, the Supreme Court of Nigeria says they are going to give their judgment on the 2nd of November. And 2nd of November is going to be next week. So Tinubu is asking the courts in America to please tell FBI to hold on, so that once they legitimize him in Nigeria, they can now use that as a weapon to begin to hunt down everyone that ask about Tinubu's forgery or Tinubu's heroin trafficking and every other thing that the Nigerian court failed to look at their evidence. They will begin to go after their and everyone that time. That's going to be their only legal backing. And they want that to happen before any FBI thing at all. So, two of the initially selected justices to be part of the panel to listen to Atiku's petition and Peter Obi's petition. Now, let us first go through that of Atiku's. Remember that Supreme Court it's not like normal court. I think I should just remind us of that because that is very important to for you to understand everything else I'm going to say about the actions and whatever operations of the Supreme Court of Nigeria. Supreme Court of Nigeria is like a policy court, kind of. It is not like the even though they act based on the constitution, they will say, but they are so privileged, okay, to, in fact, go over the constitution by looking for something else that to back whatever decision they want to make. It's like policy court kind of, sha. Oh, problem Niyama Jeba in senior, because I don't know if I give you the if I manage to really explain it the way it is. But anyway, let's leave that. So what I mean is that the Supreme Court of Nigeria can ignore constitution, kind of, in their own deliberation. And most of the time in Nigeria, they have ignored the Nigeria constitution many times, okay? And whenever they ignore the Nigerian constitution, they usually use the word, or should you use the word phrase, I mean the phrase, sake of national unity. Do you understand that? There are so many factors that they will say guides their own decision. If, for example, Nigeria constitution says, if you forged a certificate and you swear under oath that that certificate is original and they discover that it's fake, that means you have committed perjury. You have to go to jail for 10 years. That is what the Nigerian Constitution says. It's very clear. Okay? But the Supreme Court of Nigeria can tell you that for the sake of Nigeria national unity, they cannot remove Nigeria president because of forgery, even though Constitution says so. For them to remove him, they have to get, you have to prove beyond reasonable doubt that a crime has been committed. You have to convince them, not the law. Don't quote the law. Leave the law. Supreme Court of Nigeria will be like, you have to convince us. We have to be convinced that this person has committed the crime. And if he continues to be the president of Nigeria, it's going to put Nigeria in more jeopardy. And it's going to destroy unity of Nigeria. So you need to prove that to them. Not what the Constitution says. Do you understand that now? Crazy, yeah? That's why they call it a demonstration of crazy in Nigeria. And that is why Nigeria criminal politicians are very comfortable in committing electoral crime, financial crime, espionage on their own country, committed treasonable felony and all of that, because they can hire lawyers that after the first court, High Court, Appeal Court, they can go to Supreme Court and give it a different interpretation. Do you understand? Is this that messed up? Because they will say they cannot, because you or somebody in America said Tinubu's certificate is fake. You need to give us more. And now let's go into that court, how they ask, because all of their arguments, all the witnesses and everything that the tribunal, sure you get, the tribunal did not look at when they are doing their ruling and all of that. All of that, they have been forwarded to the Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court is going to look into all of that argument again. That's their job, okay? They will look into everything, all of the evidence presented, the witnesses presented by Atiku and Obi at the tribunal. They will look at them, even though tribunal has rejected them all. But their job is to look at them. If the decision of the tribunal is right or wrong. So they don't need to present all those evidences they presented during the tribunal anymore. They don't need that in the Supreme Court, okay? They don't need to present the witnesses or all of that anymore. But there is something. The Electoral Act or the Electoral Act of Nigeria is the law that guides conduct of elections, okay? Now, the Electoral Act and the law that set it up says if you are against the election results, you should file your case within 180 days. That's the Electoral Act, okay? That is not the Constitution. The Constitution that created the Electoral Act for INEC gave them that power. So, which means, within 180 days, if you need witnesses, if you have evidences, document everything, you have to get them and present them within that 180 days at the tribunal. That is the Electoral Act. So, they have done all of that. But at the Supreme Court, presenting new evidence or presenting new witnesses at the Supreme Court is not statute bar. What they mean by statute bar is that there is no law against it. Are you following me, by the way? Now, long story, oh. You dey follow me? Good. So, at the Supreme Court, hang on, at the tribunal level, there is a time that you can no longer add any new evidence. You cannot bring in any new witness, nothing. There is a time limit because of the Electoral Act, okay? But at the Supreme Court, if you have new evidence, new witnesses, you can present them. And the Supreme Court has to listen to them. because there is no law against it. And there is also no law that says Supreme Court must take them. Do you understand that now? There is no statute, there's no law that says Supreme Court must accept your new evidence. And there is also no law that says Supreme Court must reject your new evidence in an electoral matter. So which means, now the Supreme Court justices, it is going to be at their own discretion, in their own discretion, to accept it or to reject it. There is no law that says they should do or not. Do you get that now? That is number one red flag. So today, when Atiku's lawyer got there, like I said, they don't need to present everything they presented, ballot paper, everything. They don't need all of that anymore. Result sheets and all of that. They've done all of that at the tribunal. It is that evidence and all of that argument that tribunal said no evidence and then dismissed the case. That same evidence is what they want to go and present to to the Supreme Court. But Atiku is now coming with the latest evidence. And the reason why Tinubu does not want them to release the FBI documents now is because any document that implicates Tinubu can help Atiku and Obi in their case at the Supreme Court. Remember, any evidence you have, just take it to the Supreme Court. They will add it to the ones you already presented at the tribunal. Yeah? So when Atiku's lawyer walked into the courtroom, and the court started, the justices sat. So they said, my lord, because they've already filed all of those things, they've done all the filings of all the cases anyway, okay? We have new evidence that we are filing. And it is this new, under discovery, it is this new discovered evidence we want to add to say this man does not fit to be the president of Nigeria because of this new evidence under perjury under this. And the constitution says anybody that used forged documents to run for office and anything, this is what should happen. So, my lord, we want you to remove him. In Atiku's petition, back then, there is no Chicago State University evidence, like they just have this deposition now. Here you get. But they said something about him now going to Chicago State University and all of that in their primary petition. So, now the real second red flag started. When Atiku's lawyer said, we have a deposition here, my lord, from the registrar of the Chicago State University, testifying under oath that the certificates that Tinubu presented, they did not issue it. And by so doing, we want you, my lord, to disqualify Tinubu and remove him from office. That's a fresh one. In Atiku's petition at the tribunal, Atiku was asking the tribunal to, one, either disqualify Tinubu or disqualify Tinubu and declare a rerun between him and Obi, or declare a rerun between, his prayers were that the court should disqualify Tinubu, okay, and declare him winner. His second prayer was that the court should disqualify Tinubu and declare a rerun because of the Abuja 25%, that they should declare a rerun between Atiku and Obi. Now, the prayer of Atiku with this new Chicago State University is that the Supreme Court should disqualify Tinubu and then declare him a winner. That's his prayer now. Now, let us come back to the questions of the justices. Having said all that, one of the lead judge of the panel, Justice Okoro, was quoted to have asked Atiku's lawyer that, hang on, you have new evidence, yeah? Say yes. In this matter of your appeal and everything that we have seen so far, do you think we should rely on the Electoral Act or we should rely on the Constitution when we treat your appeal? And it's a very tricky question. Electoral Act says anything that has to do with academic record, whether it's qualified or is not qualified, are called pre-election matter, which means the Supreme Court of Nigeria cannot say anything that has to do with Tinubu's record, education, or what have you. They can only rule based on the conduct of the election and the evidence presented about rigging or what have you. That is the Electoral Act. If they follow the Constitution says if you forge your certificate, if you lie under oath, you should go to jail. Now, if the proof of that Tinubu has lied under oath is proven beyond reasonable doubt, that means Tinubu has not just rigged an election, he has also committed a crime that should send him to jail. So, Mr. New Evidence, with this your evidence, which also criminalized Tinubu, here you get, and should also disqualify him based on Abi. This your evidence, if we want to treat this your appeal, should we use the Constitution or the Electoral Act? It's a tricky one because nobody should be asking whether they should use the Constitution or the Electoral Act at the Supreme Court. The Constitution is the Supreme, Abi. That is why it's called Supreme Court, Abi. But nobody wrote that Constitution. No, people didn't write that. Here you get. We'll get to that part as well. So the second one is that the judge asked Atiku's lawyer, listen, we have two letters from Chicago State University. We don't know how Supreme Court got two letters from Chicago State University. But according to that justice, Justice Okoro said, we have received two letters from Chicago State University. One confirmed that Tinubu attended Chicago State University. The other one says the certificate he is parading is not from them. They did not issue it. So which one do you think we should believe now? The judge was asking Atiku's lawyer about the letters. That, okay, one is saying that he attended the school. Another one is saying that the certificate is not from them. Mr. Atiku's lawyer, which one do you think we should now believe? Asking Atiku's lawyer. That is the second or third red flag. However, the Atiku's lawyer told him to follow the law because the evidence they want to present was obtained under a strict American court system. Here is the fourth red flag. The justice, one of justice, they call the justice Agim. Abina Agim. Another new justice added to the panel last night. That one now turned around and said, wait, this your evidence, this about Chicago State University evidence that you are presenting today, did you obtain it from a courtroom? Was that gotten from a court? Asking Atiku's lawyer. Atiku's lawyer responded and said, no. But it was obtained under oath, the deposition by the registrar of Chicago State University was obtained under oath, which means it's still under the law. They said, no. Did you get that from the court? Like, was that person, that deposition, was it done inside courtroom? Atiku's lawyer said, no. It was done inside Atiku's American lawyer's office. With the presence of Tinubu's lawyers. And that was when they did the deposition. They say, okay, so you didn't do it inside the court. Now, inside Atiku's lawyers, American lawyer's office, you did the deposition. They say, yes. So it's not a courtroom. No. They now ask again, did you invite INEC to that deposition when you are doing the deposition to the Chicago State University certificate? Did you invite INEC? Is INEC part of that? The lawyer said, no. But it is valid under law. It's a deposition under law. Under oath. Like I said, fourth red flag. So that is to say, they are now saying, since you